Hey and welcome to Headbangers Kitchen. I'm your host Demon Stealer, and today we're going to be cooking up a gentleman's chicken with some mashed potatoes and some gravy. So we've got ourselves a full roasting chicken right now. And this is probably about a kilo or 1.2 kilos. Make sure you get it with the skin on, because you know the skin cooks and releases all those lovely oils of the chicken. So we're going to start by stuffing under the skin with some butter that I'm going to make right now. You take about half a stick of butter. And to this, I'm going to add some fresh thyme and rosemary. And I'm also going to add some pepper to this. Now if you're using salted butter, you don't need to add any additional salt to this. But if you're using unsalted butter or low-fat butter, you might want to add a bit of salt to it as well. And make sure your butter is at room temperature so that you can mix it in easily. We're also going to add some garlic to this, some fresh garlic. So you take about 2 or 3 cloves of garlic and crush it. Now we're going to stuff our chicken under the skin with this lovely butter that we've made. So we're going to take it in 2 spoons and make sure there's space under the skin. So with your knife, you can separate the skin from the meat. And you need to be sure not to tear the skin, you know, because then the butter will ooze out from there. Gently run your fingers under the skin so to make sure that, you know, it's not sticking. Because you want the butter to go all the way through and cook into the breast meat. So we're going to take our butter now. Take about a spoon of that butter. And just gently put it under the skin and push it forward. And then make sure you massage it in so that it reaches all the way up to the front. And we'll do that for the other side as well now. We're also going to put some of that butter under the skin of the thigh bone to give a little flavor to that area of the chicken as well. Because you want your chicken to be flavored evenly and you want that lovely taste throughout the chicken. So I like to do it around the area of the legs and the thighs as well, because that's my favorite part of the chicken. Now what we're going to do is, we're going to take some of our fresh rosemary stalks that we have and just put them into the cavity of the chicken. And what I'm also going to do is put some squeezed out lime, or actually these are not limes, these are limbu, because what happens is if you put it without squeezing it, there's a chance that the juice will cook and get very bitter. So even when you marinate the chicken, we're going to not use any of the juice, because once it cooks it starts to get bitter. However, if you have lemons available, you could definitely use the juices of the lemon to marinate the chicken as well. And we're also going to throw in some garlic into the cavity of the chicken. We'll get a bit of that nice garlicky flavor as well. Now it's time to marinate the outside of the chicken, which we're going to do with some olive oil, and then just season it with some salt and pepper. Now if you like your food spicy, you can always season it with a bit of paprika or some chili powder, you know, that's the Indian palate for you, spicy all the time. So I'm going to pour on the olive oil, just sort of rub that onto the chicken, and make sure you season both sides of the chicken, the top as well as the bottom, and then we're going to add the salt and pepper, take a generous helping of salt, make sure you season the sides as well, and the back. And then some pepper. Now what we're going to do is take some thread and tie the legs of the chicken together. So just get yourself any regular thread, and what you want to do is you want to tie these drumsticks together. I myself am just sort of learning how to do this properly, and I'm going to take the string under the wings as well, so, you know, so to get extra support. So now that it's done, we're going to move it onto our baking tray. And what you want to do is you want to put the wings underneath the nubbins so they don't get burnt. So now we're going to put this in our oven, in our preheated oven at about 250 degrees Celsius for about an hour and 15 minutes. And this chicken is a little over a kilo, so that is about enough time. The heavier the chicken, the more time it's going to need in the oven. So let's put that in now and wait for it to get cooked. So while our chicken is roasting, we're going to make some delicious mashed potatoes. And I've got some boiled potatoes here that I've peeled. And I'm just going to cut these into smaller pieces. I microwaved that butter that we had for the chicken, so I'm just going to pour some of that lovely herb butter into this mix of potatoes. So you'll have a nice herby flavor as well. And obviously, because there's not enough butter in that, we're going to add a chunk of butter to that as well. And be generous with the butter. I'm also going to add some milk to this. And you could use cream alternatively if you want it to be richer and creamier. And I'm just going to season this with a little bit of pepper and some salt as well. And don't put too much salt, you can always add more salt later if you require. So now what we're going to do is we're going to microwave this for about a minute and then we're going to mash it. The mashed potatoes are done. And now we're going to check on our chicken and see if that's done as well. So our chicken is done now, and as you can see, it's a beautiful color. The skin is nice and crispy. And now we're just going to put this on the side and allow it to rest for about 10 minutes. We're going to make our gravy now, and we're going to do that by using all these lovely pan juices and the butter that is melted, and just pour that into a saucepan or a frying pan to make your gravy. And we're going to add 2 tablespoons of flour to this and whisk that in. And just take a whisk and let it absorb all those juices and let the flour cook as well. And you can smell all that lovely butter and the rosemary and the thyme. It's amazing. So you let this flour cook a little bit for about 2-3 minutes, maybe even 5 if you like. And we're going to add some chicken stock to this now. You can use about 1/2 cup to a cup of chicken stock depending on how much gravy you want. If you don't have chicken stock, you can alternatively use stock cubes or Maggi cubes. But I'll be really honest, I've tried them and they don't quite match up to the flavor of a real chicken stock. So you can always make a whole lot of stock and just freeze it and use it whenever you want to make some gravy like this. And you can see it's getting a lovely brown caramelized color. Our sauce is now at the perfect consistency and it looks delicious. I need to taste it though. Always taste your sauce and make sure it's seasoned well. That's really good. I'm just going to add a little bit of lime juice to that to give it a little bit of freshness. Just that much. And we're going to turn our gas off now. And just mix that in. And like I said before, don't cook the lime juice because it gets bitter. We're going to pour our gravy out now into our serving dish. So here it is, the gentleman's roast chicken with some mashed potatoes and some lovely pan gravy to go with it.